Hello! Today I've got a shorter video than usual. Don't worry, I've got a bigger video planned on the progress of survival mode, but a few days ago I discovered this cool little trick that made the lightning so much more dynamic, and I think it deserves its own little video. As a quick reminder, Cubyz uses floodfill lighting just like Minecraft, but with a 32 block range and support for RGB lighting. And well, floodfill lighting has one big flaw. It's too smooth and there are no shadows. There are many ideas how to fix that, but in the past I've always rejected them because they would just be too slow. But Ikabod kept complaining about it, so I decided to give him a quick and dirty prototype to prove once and for all that there's no way this would look any good without being too expensive. But I accidentally discovered the perfect solution. We basically want to give all faces facing away from the nearest light source a slight shadow. But sadly, the floodfill algorithm does not tell us where the light source is. In fact, in the worst case, there might be many sources of different colors. What we can do, however, is checking the next light sample in the direction of the normal. If it's darker than the current sample, then we know that it must face away from the light source, and so that face is in the shadow. This is totally inaccurate, but somehow it works great. As long as you don't make the shadows too dark, of course. We found that 2.5 blocks of the usual light propagation worked well in that regard. This can be done for all color channels, giving us these awesome results. That's it for today. Goodbye.